Hi everyone, Sonya Belousova here, composer for Netflix The Witcher, and today we'll take a look at the time of axe and sword is now. This track is pretty complex, both thematically and instrumentation-wise. There are several themes that are very closely intertwined within this track. The virtuosic aspect is also very important as the solo violin takes the lead in the middle section. So let's not waste any time and let's jump right into it. First of all, there are the drums of war, centuries under attack. These are the same drums that were introduced earlier in the episode, in the Battle of Marna del Q. We recorded several drums for this. It's a combination of timpani, very reverby snare, and the bass drum. This scene is very particular, as it happens twice in season one. First time we see it in episode one, and then it comes back again in episode seven. The difference is that in episode one, we see it from Ciri's perspective, and in episode seven, from Geralt's perspective. Which is why it was incredibly important for us to feature both Ciri and Geralt's themes. And so the very first thing that you hear in this track is in fact Ciri's theme that comes in the vocals. Throughout the whole season, Ciri's theme is performed by both Hoon and violin, and it usually goes like this. La, la, da, da, la, da, da. And that Ciri's theme right there. And what's interesting about this theme is that it's performed by both Declan DeBarra and myself. Declan DeBarra is a writer and supervising producer on the series, and we recorded quite a few songs with him. And what's interesting about this performance is that I sing in my natural register, yeah, 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 yeah. So for me, that's a comfortable register. Declan sings exactly in unison with me. So he basically sings the same exact notes. But however, for him, it's a pretty high register. So the sound that he produces in this register is very strained. And therefore, our vocals combined together in unison create this very, very particular, very harsh, very strained sonority. Let's take a look at this motif right here. It's this really cool bend that we created with a double bass, and we feature it throughout the whole season. It's especially prominent in episode 5 with Mao's second Doppler storyline. So let's just take a look at it. Pretty cool, isn't it? Here is another really cool element. This is a battle horn that we recorded specifically for this scene. This battle horn is doubled by several elements. It's low brass, low synths, and low growling. Let's take a look at it. And now the growling is going to be reversed.
Hope and doom forlorn, her path could lead to
These vocals have been recorded by the magnificent Declan de Barra, who also wrote these beautiful lyrics. In fact, this is the very first time we introduced the motif of the Last Rose of Sintra, which will appear in its full glory in episode 5. The vocals in this section are really grim, tamed, even ghostly, because Kalanta is dying and therefore Ciri is terrified. She's about to embark on her journey on her own. The strings come in, underlining the gravity and the tragedy of the situation, also making it more emotional. You really feel for Ciri and for what she's about to go through.
Most of future's fallen have saddled up to ride. Seeking the lack of a century, that's living over a pride. Every hand will reach for the power lies untold. The time of accents is now. Good receives a war, a soul, a soul.
Together with Declan's vocals, there is another very important element that comes in here. Let me show this instrument to you. So this little thing right here is called a hun. This is basically a Chinese flute or Chinese ocarina made out of clay, and we use this little guy right here for Ciri's theme throughout the whole season. It produces this very breathy, very airy type of sound. And this is a modified version of Ciri's theme that plays as a counterpoint to the main vocal melody. In order to propel us forward, we gently start introducing groove elements. So we've got three things right here. We've got sultry, hi-hats, and shakers. Let's take a look at them. Strings come in again, however, this time with a major chord. So check this out. The key is an E minor, however, the strings come in with a C major chord, which creates a stark contrast with what's happening on screen and makes it even more tragic and more emotional. Let's take a look at them. Gets reprised with vocals, just as we heard it in the very beginning of this track.
The time of accents is now. Good receives a war, a soul, a soul. We'll be right back.
probably the most gripping and emotional part of this track, and to tell you the truth, it really gets me every single time. This section keeps growing, developing, it keeps building the intensity and expanding in the registers to lead us into this section, the vocal sank serious theme. However, now that we're in this section, as soon as we get into it, the vocals switch into Geralt's theme. Both Ciri and Geralt are participants in this scene without even knowing that. And therefore, it was incredibly important for us to feature their thematic material. I'll start from a little bit earlier so you can hear how the vocals sank serious theme and then make a switch into Geralt's theme. Note, we end on E5. So the fact that Declan is able to sing that high, but also that low, I mean, his register is just absolutely mind-blowing to me. And the sound he produces, that strain in his sound, it was just working so perfectly for this scene. I absolutely love this vocal part. And I'd like to reinstate that point again about us singing in unison. We sing the same exact notes, but because that register is so different for us, for me it's a more natural register, for Declan it's so much higher and so much more strained, it produces a very particular and a very peculiar sonority. It's kind of together, but at the same time, it's not together at all. We also put some distortion on these vocals to make them even more edgy. In order to make this video more concise, we decided to break it into two parts. Hope you enjoyed part one and stay tuned for part two. As soon as part two is available, you'll be able to click on the link right here that will direct you to watch the second installment of this video. Thanks again for watching and stay tuned for part two.